It's gonna be.
Everyone deserves a second chance, especially when it comes to saving the environment. Instead of dumping your drinks in the road or parking lot, wait and pour them out at home. Pick up after your pet. Put your trash into garbage bags. Wind turns loose trash into litter. And keep leaves out of the gutter. Dump them in a trash bin. Remember, when it comes to stormwater pollution, a change for the better begins with you. Think blue.
Swallow the wind through my nose, feel the sand beneath my toes. As I walk along the shore, it's like a a deep inside me somewhere. It's like a la-di-da-da-dee-dee, happiness is calling me.
Happiness is calling at sandiego.org.
5 minutes.
Win a Concept 2 ergonometer delivered right to your door. Raffle tickets are available at the Concept 2 CTS tent here on campus. And, you know, about 30 minutes after each race, you can stop by the merchandise tent and pick up a DVD copy of a race that has been run with a loved one in it. They're only $15. They're beautifully photographed and an opportunity to have a fine souvenir of the 40th annual San Diego Crew Classic. Goldfield Stage is your perfect choice for transporting your winning team from event to event with reliability and ease. Whether it's your crew, your golf team, your fans, whatever, they can handle from 15 to hundreds. Call Goldfield Stage 619-579-5300 and ride the wave in style.
This is the time. This is the turning point. This is more than just a game. This is a way of life. This is the drive that brings the breaking point. We'll be swinging for the fences, battling in the trenches tonight.
My suggestion is that.
Event number 81, Women's Collegiate Varsity Invitational Grand Final. Lane assignments, Lane 1, University of Southern California. Lane 2, University of Virginia. Lane 3, California. Lane 4, University of Washington. Lane 5, Duke University. Lane 6, UCLA. Yeah. We have 3 minutes until the start. The best of the best women rowers here at the regatta.
Charles, we're going to look for just a second on this outstanding women's race and then get your take on it, and then also get the take of Mary Whipple. She is a coxswain from the Olympic crew, and let's see what you guys have to say about what we're going to be seeing.
Mary's not only a coxswain from the Olympic crew, she's an Olympic gold medalist. So there's not much that Mary does not know about the art of making a boat go fast. Mary, how do you see this premier event at the regatta, the Jessup Whittier Cup, sorting itself out during the course of this race?
Well, we're going to see who actually put a lot of time into winter training, who did some extra workouts. This is the first shot these women have at each other to kind of stake their claim on their NCAA campaign.
Excellent. And how much is this first hit out, how much is it worth in terms of bragging rights later on in the season and going to the NCAA championships?
Well, the boat who figures their bow ball across the line first, they know winter training worked. They know maybe this lineup is the lineup. The people who don't have the race that they want, they're going to dust the cobwebs off, maybe reassign some seats, go back to maybe some seat racing and figure some stuff out. So this is a great first showing of what the caliber of racing that the women's event has come.
And of course, in lane two, we have a crew from all the way across the other side of the country, the University of Virginia, and I think they have something to prove on the basis of last year's results.
Absolutely. UVA is the crew to watch because they are NCAA champions. Kevin Sauer runs a great program. They are deep, they are fast, and they are ready to come out and show them why they were so fast last year.
So who do you think is going to be that big challenger today?
Well, if we looked at the times from yesterday, I mean, we've got USC was the other heat winner. And if times indicate anything, no. I know everybody has their opinions about timing and all that stuff, but it's great commentary about they pulled the same time, minus the tenths. And then you've got 2 seconds back, Cal and
USC.
And Washington, their rivals,
Virginia.
And this is going to be a four-boat race.
California.
What do you think about UCLA and Duke on the outside?
Duke.
Outside lane
UCLA.
Smokers. It's a six. Everybody
Attention.
Is capable of winning.
Go!
Jim Jorgensen down at the start line. Jim?
They're off. Here we go. Absolutely pristine conditions for this grand final of event number 81, Women's Collegiate Varsity Invitational. Varsity rowers do come off the line a lot cleaner than the novices, and right now your early leader in lane 3, University of California. Cal with probably a two-seat advantage over University of Virginia. University of Southern California is right there. Then Washington, followed by Duke University. UCLA actually battling for a third or fourth position as we pass the 250-meter mark. But your race leader, the Golden Bears, lane 3, now with 6 to 7 seats over Virginia, Washington, University of Southern California,
and two,
UCLA,
bam,
and then Duke
bam.
University.
All right.
Very smooth. Nice cadence. Let me take a stroke check here.
7 seat of use of USC. Here we go. Stern 4. Start it right.
Bears still rowing.
Right, this 4. 1.
Upper stroke rates here.
2.
As we approach the 500 meter mark.
4.
Cal Berkeley.
5.
Excuse me. California now crosses that 500 meter mark in the first position, followed by Virginia. Then it's too close to call between Washington, USC, and UCLA. That's the call, 600 meters. Great racing.
This is one of the premier races here at the San Diego Crew Classic as we listen to the University of Virginia coxswain being Mike. checking lane assignments quickly. It is USC in lane number one. Virginia battling for the first spot in lane two. Cal is in lane three and currently on the lead. It is Washington in lane four, Duke in lane five, and UCLA out in lane number six.
This is the grand final of the Jessup Whittier Trophy, and it is the premier women's event at this regatta. The form crews out of the heats, as Mary said, are UVA and USC, who did 6:24s both in the heats. They're in lanes one and two, closely tracked by Cal and UW, University of Washington, who did 6:26 in the heats. Mary, how are you seeing this race panning out? I know you've had a stroke watch on it. Who looks like they're making the move at the right cadence?
Kara Kohler is stroking her Cal women's crew in the lead at around 36-37. Everybody else is cruising around 35-36 range. They're getting into crossing into the 1,000, and we're going to see if the Cal women crew is going to back Kara Kohler up and finish this race.
Who do you see putting in the big move in the third 500?
Third 500 is all about guts. Washington loves to charge late. UVA, they are national champions, and they are going to make everybody earn any seat they have on them.
Anything you're noticing in particular that's impressing you about the performance of any of the crews?
I see highly focused internal crews executing their race plan. Nobody's getting shaken. And it's going to be powerful strokes from Cal right here in that shot. Very good impulse, very good leverage. If they can just sit up, close their eyes, and believe, they can do this.
Approaching 1,250 meters. Into this race, it's California continuing to move along in the first spot, but they are being seriously challenged by Virginia. Virginia is the coxswain that is mic'd here that you're listening to. And then Washington in the center of the field, SC along the shoreline, UCLA outside, and Duke is trailing.
One walking on Cal.
Watch out for the Huskies. They do take a late charge. They're going up to about 36. That coxswain, if I was her, I'd be saying, we're moving. We can do this. Same thing with UVA's coxswain. She is giving them everything that they need to execute that race plan.
Washington is creeping up, and it looks like they may have come right up and challenged Cal and maybe even got a nose in front of them. So it appears to be Washington, Virginia, and then check that. Washington, Cal, and Virginia, then going to the outside. We are looking at UCLA, and Duke is trailing. They are approaching 500 meters, and it appears that Washington has nosed into the lead. California in second spot, but Virginia has not gone away. They are almost bow marker to bow marker. And then look out on the outside. UCLA has begun to make a move, and then Duke at the end of the field.
I think the main challenge now is coming from a hard-charging USC crew in lane one. Mary.
They've earned lane one by winning that last or that heat yesterday. Trojans are hearing their band. This is going to take all strokes in the last 250 to come away.
Cal seem to be coming under pressure. They're coming under pressure from University of Virginia and the hard-charging USC in lane one.
This is NCAA women's rowing at its finest. We've got three boats capable of winning.
California on the lead in lane number three, but they are being seriously challenged by USC with a furious charge along the shoreline. It is USC and California. And all the way to the outside, don't forget UCLA. Washington is also in the hunt. Only crew trailing is Duke. Along the shoreline, it is USC. California, USC. USC by a bow. California in second spot. Outside, look at UCLA. Virginia fading to fourth. Washington and then Duke. On the shoreline, USC making a furious charge. USC in the lead. California in that second spot. They're going to look at Virginia fading just a little bit. Outside UCLA a little bit too little too late. But USC with an impressive row along the shoreline. They came out of nowhere and overtook the leader Cal and Virginia. Looks like UCLA will finish four, followed by Washington and Duke. Outstanding charge by USC along the shoreline. They are closest to the shore, farthest away from our picture view, and they scoot in there and pick up about a six-seat victory over California, followed by Virginia, UCLA, Washington, and Duke. Unofficially, they are the winners, USC, of the Jessup Whittier Cup 2013's 40th annual San Diego Crew Classic.
Mary, your thoughts on that race, having seen it?
I think there's going to be a lot of crews pleased with how they executed their first full-on race plan in a grand final. There's going to be some other crews going back home, circling the date to their next race and seeing if they can squeeze in some extra workouts, squeeze in some extra technical workouts. We've got a lot of hungry athletes out there in more ways than one, and they're going to get back to work.
Mary, thank you very much for your insight into this race. It's been highly instructive.
We are getting ready for the other premier event here at the San Diego Crew Classic, the Copley Cup. Event number 82 will be coming up. It is the Men's Collegiate Varsity Invitational Grand Final. And checking who is involved, it is California, Stanford, University of British Columbia, Pennsylvania, Gonzaga, and Oregon State.